Abby, thanks so much. Well, in a matter of days, abused women in Elkhart County could be without a shelter.
The Family Services of Elkhart County's Women's Shelter announced it's going to close in the next few days because of financial problems. WSBT 22 Zach Crenshaw is at the live desk. And Zach, will this shelter close for good now?
Hopefully not, Cindy. It will likely be changing names if it stays open, though. But that depends on one St. Joseph County Women's Shelter and possibly the public.
The Elkhart County Women's Shelter is a safe haven.
Annually, it serves 460 women and children that come in and out of our doors that are seeking refuge for domestic violence issues.
But that refuge may soon disappear.
Police are bringing in women and babies, women and kids every day that are beaten up, and just the idea that Elkhart, these services wouldn't be there if we can't find a way to make it happen.
We really need to raise a significant amount of dollars to cover these expenses to help aid a partner that would take this on.
Fortunately, there is a partner.
YWCA, can I help you?
Family Services Board came to the YWCA only about 6 weeks ago and said that they were in financial distress and they wanted us to take over operations of Elkhart County Women's Shelter and transitional housing.
Linda Beckley is the CEO at the St. Joseph County YWCA. And says they're considering running Elkhart County's operation.
Women need some place to go.
But the facility needs to stay afloat this time.
We're realizing that it's going to cost us about $220,000 more a year to make sure that these services are in place.
The YWCA is still trying to figure out the financial details, but says with the community's help, they can hopefully continue to provide Elkhart women shelter.
It's our hope that it can be our Christmas miracle here, that we're gonna keep it open. And
now the YWCA says since the Family Services Women's Shelter could be closing down any day now, if you're looking to make a donation, make it out to the YWCA in St. Joseph County. We have more information on how you can help on our website, WSBT.com. At the live desk, Zach Crenshaw, WSBT 22 News.